एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ ईशा के जोशी, लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, बीपीएमपी पॉलिटेक्निक। माय सब्जेक्ट इज एनालॉग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड द यूनिट नेम इज नेगेटिव फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर्स एंड टॉपिक इज वोल्टेज सीरीज फीडबैक। सो आवर ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू डिस्कस सर्किट डायग्राम ऑफ वोल्टेज सीरीज फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर and analysis of voltage series feedback amplifier. So we can know that what should be the input impedance and the output impedance if we use voltage series feedback amplifier circuit. Voltage series feedback. You can see the circuit diagram of voltage series feedback. And this circuit is also called as ammeter follower. It is a negative feedback type circuit. The ammeter follower is a circuit that has no voltage gain. Its most important characteristic is that it has high input impedance and low output impedance, and this makes it an ideal circuit for impedance matching. Now if we see the circuit in detail, then in this circuit it differs from the circuitry of conventional CE amplifier by the absence of collector load and ammeter bypass capacitor. The ammeter resistance, this RE, itself acts as the load, and AC output voltage, this is output voltage, is taken across RE. The biasing is generally provided by voltage divider method or by base resistor method. Some points worth noting about this ammeter follower is, in this circuit you can see there is neither a collector resistor in the circuit nor there is ammeter bypass capacitor. These are two circuit recognition features of this ammeter follower circuit, and the collector, operation, if we see the operation of this circuit, then the input voltage, this is our input voltage, here is the supply voltage, and the input voltage is applied between base and ammeter terminal, and it resulting as the ammeter current produces an output voltage. Here this output voltage, which is equal to IERE across the ammeter resistance. So here we get the output voltage, which is equal to IERE. This voltage opposes the input voltage. This output voltage opposes the input voltage and thus providing negative feedback. Clearly it is a negative feedback circuit since the voltage feedback is proportional to the ammeter current. Here the voltage feedback is proportional to ammeter current. So we can say it is proportional to output current, and so it is called ammeter follower. So that is the reason why it is called ammeter follower. Here the voltage feedback, this voltage feedback is proportional to ammeter current, or we can say it is proportional to output current, and so it is called ammeter follower circuit. So this is how the voltage series feedback circuit functions. Now let us see the block diagram of voltage series feedback. So you can see the block diagram on your screen, and in this block diagram you can see the input of amplifier and feedback circuit. This is the input of an amplifier, this is input of an amplifier, and this is the feedback circuit. Both are in series, but the output are in parallel. In this block diagram, the input to the feedback network is in parallel with the output of an amplifier. A fraction of the output voltage is applied in series with the input voltage of an amplifier through a feedback network. A voltage series feedback amplifier, we can say it is a true voltage amplifier circuit. And in this circuit, the series connection at the input increases the input impedance, and the shunt connection at the output reduces the output impedance, as I have said earlier. So it has a main characteristic that it has high input impedance and low output impedance. Now let's analyze the voltage series feedback circuit. So firstly, we calculate the input impedance. So to calculate input impedance, here we have supply voltage Vs is equal to Vi plus Vf. Here is input voltage and plus feedback voltage. As we know that Vf is equal to, from this equation we know that Vf is equal to beta into Vo. So we know that Vf is equal to beta Vo. So by putting the value of Vf in this equation, we will get Vs is equal to Vi plus beta Vo. So here we also know that Vo is equal to A into Vi. So here we have the value of Vo, A into Vi. So by putting this value of Vo into this equation, we will get Vs is equal to Vi plus beta AVi. Now by simplifying this equation, Vs is equal to Vi is common, taking Vi as a common, Vi into bracket 1 plus A beta. Now we know Vi is equal to Ii into Zi. We know the equation of impedance, and from that equation Vi is equal to Ii into Zi. So Vs is equal to, by putting the value of Vi in this equation, Ii Zi 1 plus A beta. So here Vs upon Ii is equal to Zi 1 plus A beta. We want this equation in a form of impedance equation. So we know as input impedance with feedback is, input impedance with feedback is ZIF is equal to Vs upon Ii. So here putting the value of impedance, input impedance with feedback in this equation, we will get the equation ZIF is equal to Zi into bracket 1 plus A beta. So from this equation we can easily conclude that in voltage series feedback circuit, it increases the input impedance by factor 1 plus A beta. So in voltage series feedback circuit, input impedance increases by factor 1 plus A beta. So this is about input impedance. Now let us calculate the output impedance. So from this block diagram, we will calculate output impedance To calculate the output impedance, we have here VO is equal to IOZO plus A into VI. From this block diagram, we can write this equation. VO is equal to IOZO plus A into VI. So, here we have VI is equal to minus VF. Putting the value of VI in this equation, we have VO is equal to IOZO minus A into VF. As we know, VF is equal to beta VO, that we have already used this equation in calculation of input impedance. So again, we are putting the value of VF in this equation. We will get VO is equal to IOZO minus A into beta VO. So VO plus, if we take this alpha A beta VO in this side, then it will become plus A beta VO is equal to IOZO. Therefore, VO, if we take VO common 1 plus A beta is equal to IOZO. Therefore, VO upon IO is equal to ZO upon 1 plus A beta. From this equation, we can write this equation in this way also to get the output impedance, because this is the equation of output impedance as we know. So we can write in place of this, the output impedance with feedback is equal to ZO upon 1 plus A beta. This is our final equation of output impedance. So from this equation, we can say that in voltage series feedback circuit, the output impedance decreases by factor 1 plus A beta. So this is about the calculation of input impedance and output impedance of voltage series feedback. Next time, we will discuss about the current shunt feedback and current series feedback. Thank you.